better.
So did you put a steak on that or anything old school?
Just iced it.
How's it feeling?
It's all right. You know, just pretty sore. It's not so what looks. It's more the eye. So, yeah.
Did it affect your vision at all yesterday, or like were you? How did you play through it?
I don't really remember. You just kept going. You know, yeah. Just we just had a win. Yeah.
When you say it's the eye, what do you mean?
Like it's the eye, like looking to this left and right. You know, it's not actually all this stuff that's swollen. I don't really feel that. It's the actual eye. Yeah.
Do you wear a mask tomorrow?
No, I can't do that.
Can they do any treatment to it? I mean, it's
obvious. There's nothing. Yeah, nothing you can do.
Look as bad as yesterday.
Yeah, just let it recover by itself.
Did they check your orbit?
Yeah, they did. They did all that right after the game.
Okay, and you're good.
Yeah.
How I don't know if surprising is the right word, but pleasantly surprised, gratified with what happened last night when kind of reflect back less than 24 hours later?
You know, we're just excited we have this chance to come here and play game 7 at home with our fans. So that's the biggest part, you know. We felt like some games we didn't play our best, you know, but at this point it doesn't really matter. We just got to go out there and play our best game tomorrow.
This is going to be 3 games in 5 nights. Does it kind of feel like emulating a little bit of what you guys prepared for in the regular season?
Yeah, you know, I mean, we're a team that's played fast all year, you know, been aggressive no matter what the schedule is. So I don't expect that to change tomorrow.
The fact excuse that you're the reference, given your eye, but Mike's talked about, you know, an MMA reference saying you guys have to knock them out. You're not going to win by a decision. How has that hit your ears, and how do you think the teams respond?
I think it's good, you know. I mean, I don't think the game's going to be pretty tomorrow. You know, knowing both teams, you know, it's whoever wins, you know, once the buzzer goes off and whoever has the most points, you know. So I think we're just going to come out there and fight, you know, every position.
How do you keep this from being game 7, winner take all, season on the line, and try and treat it like a normal game? Or do you just have to embrace the fact that, this isn't normal?
I prefer that. It's game 7. You know, guys might come in and lock in from the jump, you know, and just be aggressive throughout the whole game. You know, there's no excuse to take a possession off or two. You know, you just got to go out there and give everything you got.
From that standpoint, is it the same as last night because you were facing elimination?
Yeah, of course, but now we're at home. You know, we have our fans. If we win, we move on, you know. So, I mean, if that doesn't motivate you, I don't know what else can.
The fact that you're going to be at home with these fans and what this environment has shown, is that kind of what the whole regular season was for, getting that top 3 seed, getting that home court advantage?
Yeah, I mean, I'm just happy for the city and the fans, you know, to experience a game 7 against the champions, you know, against a team like that that's right up the road, you know. I think it's going to be special. It's going to be a special day.
With all the emotions that happened in game 1 with the scene and the energy and everything, are there things you can learn from that that'll help you so you don't get maybe overexcited tomorrow?
I don't know. I feel everyone's going to be excited no matter what happens. It's game 7. You're going against the champions, you know, at home, you know, with these fans. So I think we're all just excited. You know, we just got to rest up and be ready for it.
There's a lot of emphasis on spacing last game. I imagine going into this next one, like, how does that impact the game for you? Not only the guys around you, but yourself. Like, it seemed like, you know, you're taking that elbow jumper more in the corner a little bit.
You know, we've just been working on what we've been working all series, and coaches have been changing little things throughout each game, and we've been executing them, you know, so we just got to keep doing it with confidence.
Have you noticed that maybe the Warriors playing a little bit more with more fatigue, or Trey said that he still says that Steph, Clay, and Grimm are running around like 19-year-old guys out there?
Everyone keeps saying that, but, you know, we're on the court guarding them. I think they're doing the same thing. They're still running around. They're still being physical, you know, so we just not got to listen to that and expect anything and just keep playing our game.
You mentioned the word excited a lot throughout this. You know, coming into this, how much pressure do you guys feel with this being on your home court and whatnot?
I don't think it's pressure at all. You know, we've worked our way here, you know, to this point. No one expected us to be here anyway, you know. And the fact that we can play a game 7, you know, in my career, I played one before, and it's an amazing game, you know, to play in and just be part of that experience. So the fact that we can do it at home, it's going to be fun.
Individually, I mean, how are you feeling? I mean, there's obviously probably been the most frustrated we've seen you all season in terms of just these games that are strung together. They obviously have some great defensive looks towards you. As you navigate that, just where's your frustration level at in this series?
Nowhere. You know, we have game 7 tomorrow. You know, at the end of the day, the goal is to win and move forward. So if we can win and move forward, you're happy. You know, that's the main thing. You know, every series change, matchups change and everything. So our goal is just to win. Like I said, it's not going to be pretty tomorrow. We just got to be the ones winning more.
Well, which game 7 did you plan, and what were the differences between that game and other playoff games you've been
playing? We're playing LeBron in Cleveland, so it's a whole different thing.
Okay. Domantas, Mike is focused, you guys, all season long on one game at a time, one day at a time. How much is that for playing out right now as you guys are going through this series?
It's worked. You know, we've had that mentality all year, you know, even when we started bad, then we went on a little run. Same thing, you know, we can only control what's in front of us right now, you know, and right now it's game seven.
Coach gave you a lot of credit for, you and Trey, credit for taking away the pocket defensively. Like, what is the key to doing that?
Can't sell all our secrets out right now, but we just got to keep doing the same thing.
Domas, you mentioned the LeBron game, but this is Steph playing LeBron,
yeah.
And they've seen everything.
Yeah.
I mean, like, with that in mind, what did you sense from them yesterday? Because it felt like everybody, maybe even them, was ready for your squad to roll over. It didn't happen.
I'm just proud of my team. I knew we were going to come out and fight no matter what. You know, this team hasn't put our head down all season long, you know, so I wasn't expecting that. Even if they went on a run or vice versa, you know, we just had to keep going at them all game.
But with the Warriors side, I mean, safe to assume they've, I don't know how many they've done at this point, game 7-1.
Mm-hmm.
The focus got to be at an incredible level to match that?
Yeah, of course. Focus got to be crazy because one position can change the whole game. We can be tied, and then in a matter of 40 seconds, we're down 10 or whatever, you know. So we just got to be locked in, you know. Thankfully, we're at home, and we have our fans to help us, and we're just going to go out there and do everything we can.
For a team that hasn't been known for defense, to hold them under 100 points on their home floor, what kind of, I don't know, momentum can that bring you going into tomorrow?
It's just effort, you know, and we can't think like, oh, we did it, and we can relax tomorrow, you know. We got to keep doing it and do it even better because tomorrow is just going to be a fight.
Back to Sam's question, I mean, so much has been made about the Warriors' experience, right? What can you say, though, about your guys' maturity, your ability to stay extremely level-headed even though you are the less experienced team to force game 7
and stay in this? You know, the guys have just been locked in, putting in work, watching film, doing everything. Coach has been amazing, telling us just to focus one game at a time. We lost 3 in a row there. You know, people could have just said, whatever, let's go on vacation, you know. But this team is locked in, you know. We know we can do more and we can go further. So it starts with winning more.